Hey guys, this is Dan Stevers from danstevers.com, and today we're going to be talking about how to edit your movies and animations to a beat inside of both Final Cut and After Effects. I'll show you the whole process of how I lay these things out, starting in Final Cut, roughing it out, and then taking it into After Effects to do the final animations and sync it all up to music. And I'll show you some cool techniques that are going to make working inside of After Effects dealing with music a lot easier. So let's just jump into it. All right, so this project is going to begin and end inside of Final Cut. So what we're going to do first inside of Final Cut is we're going to edit our music. And rarely will you ever find a music track that you need to work with in a video that is perfectly suited lengthwise to the length of your video. I pretty much always have to edit the music that I use inside of a video. So I got this track here, I'm gonna drop it in, and I'm also just gonna change it to my custom layout here, which makes these guys a big bit fatter there. I'm also gonna go ahead and turn on the audio waveforms, and this just makes it easier when you're working with audio to see what's going on here. Okay, so we're gonna just take a listen to this for a second here. It's a pretty jamming track. Okay, so it's grooving along there, but it's grooving for too long. What I'm interested in are some sections at the end where the music gets a little more interesting, because I like how it starts there, but I don't like how long it takes for this song to build up. I'm gonna probably try to edit this to like 15 seconds long, so we just want the good stuff. See, that's where I think it gets pretty cool right there. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do is I'm gonna play the music and I'm gonna count along to the beats there, and I'm gonna count along until I get to the one at this new section of the song here. I'll show you what I mean here. So I'm just gonna play it here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, boom. And what I did right there is I hit the space bar right on the one, because we're talking in music terms here, and so there, there are four quarter notes in a bar there, or in a measure. So I want to be editing this at the start of the next measure. So I'm just hitting 1, 2, 3, 4, boom. And so that's my edit point right there. So I'm gonna hit B to go to blade, and it should snap right onto our timeline marker there. And so I'm just gonna chop that there. I'm gonna hit A to go back to my selection tool there. I'm gonna zoom out a little bit here. What we're gonna need to do is we're gonna need to do an edit at the beginning point there too. So I'm just gonna count along with it too, and I'm just gonna make my edit where I feel like I want it there. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. And I was a little bit early there, so I'll scoot it over. And I'm gonna hit B again, and I'm gonna slice it there. I'm gonna hit A to go back to my regular selection tool here. And I'm just gonna select this section right here. I'm gonna zoom this out right here. Select this middle section, and we're just getting rid of it because we're editing our music, so we get just what we want here. I'm gonna zoom back in a little bit. Now this edit, we're probably gonna have to refine this. Well, actually, we're definitely gonna have to refine this, but let's just see how this is sounding here. So it's going from this section of the song right here to this section of the song. Okay, so it's a little rough right now, and the main thing we want to make sure is that we're right on the beat there, because we're going to be adding a crossfade between these, which will kind of smooth over the edit. I think it's right on the beat there. I'm going to give a little more room at the start of this and just tweak it a little bit just so the edit points right where we want it. I'm gonna go to effects up here. I'm gonna go to audio transitions and crossfade. Now I'm gonna be using crossfade plus 3 dB there. And the reason for that is if you use the regular crossfade, you'll notice a dip in the volume as you crossfade. If you use the plus 3, it should just be a smooth transition there. So I'm gonna shrink it down a little bit by just grabbing the edges of the crossfade and shrinking a little bit. So let's play it and see how it sounds now. There we go, that's sounding pretty good now. Okay, so that edit sounds good there. I'm gonna do another edit right where I want it to be, and actually I stopped it roughly where we want it to be there, but I'm just gonna play it again and count it out, just because I always like to try and time it with my space bar, just so I'm right on the money there, right on the beat. So I'm just gonna play it again. 2, 3, 4, boom. So that is where I want my next edit point. So I'm gonna do the same thing, hit B, slice it there. And I think we're gonna go to the end of the song here, and I just want this last little note at the end of the song here. So I'm just gonna count it out again and just hit space bar, stop it right on the beat where I want it. 2, 3, 4, boom. Okay. Because I just want that little note there right at the end. So I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna select this giant middle chunk here, delete it, drag over my new edit, and we should be looking pretty good right here. So let's go ahead and play it. All right, it's all a little rough sounding. You know, often when you're doing these edits, you just gotta go in and add or take away a frame just to make sure it's right on the beat there. So I'm just gonna fine tune this right now. So it looks like I'm cutting it off maybe a, let's try it one, moving it one frame out. See, there we go. See that one frame difference right there that I added made all the difference when we're editing it. Let's play it again. Cool. Sounds pretty stinking good. now, when you're editing chunks together, they may or may not sound good going from one chunk to the other. Just depending on the music, just depending. There's a lot of factors of why it could sound odd when you're editing it together. I'll show you a little trick that I do when I'm having edits that aren't working together really well. I've got on my computer these things called reverse cymbal swells. So I'm just going to do a search up here. Reverse cymbal, show all. So I've got these things that are called rising cymbal reverse, or basically they're just called cymbal swells, but they're in reverse. They just take the sound and they reverse it. So I'll show you what that sounds like. So it's just this big rising cymbal sound. And what this helps do is it helps cover up really awkward edits. So I'll drag it into my timeline there. I'm just gonna plop it in. Now before I start messing around with this, you may be thinking, well, I don't have that on my computer. Well, you actually might, depending on your what software you've got on there, what video editing software, because I think the Final Cut Suite comes with a bunch of sounds in there. So that might very well may be one of the sounds that comes on your computer. If you don't have it, just go to this awesome website called soundsnap.com. And if you just do a search for reverse cymbal, you should be able to come up with a lot of things there. So they've got all these free sounds here. All you have to do is make an account here, and you can listen to the sounds here. And so you can check them out, and you can download them for free, and so try them out in your project. And so now I'll show you how you use these guys here. So I was just trying to line it up so it's like So the big chunk of it is right on the edit point there. So that where it gets loudest is about where we want the cymbal swell to come in. I think it's gonna be too loud right now, but we'll just play it anyways, so. So I'll play it without the cymbal swell first. Okay, now we'll check it out with the cymbal swell added, even though it's gonna be too loud, but whatever. Okay, so I'm gonna first of all drop the I'm gonna drop the level of the music here like 8 dBs because it's overpowering right now. But what it does is it just helps add a natural swell into the edit point and a swell out of the edit point. So it just basically smooths over a really awkward edit. Now this edit's not that weird, but you may run into some that are kind of weird, and adding this cymbal swell over it really just helps smooth it out and sound a lot more natural. You might be able to fool people to think that you didn't hack up a piece of music to make your video. So let's just hear it again now. Cool. Now you could do this on any edit point here. I can move this over to this edit point right here to like if this one was sounding weird too, and we could just try it with that. So yeah, it's fine though. It's not real necessary in this video, but I just wanted to show you it as a good option if your edits are sounding weird there. I think we'll just leave it on the end there, just for fun. Okay, so now that we've got this track here, I should probably go ahead and save my project. I'm really bad at saving my project sometimes, and then things go crazy, and you know, it gets pretty ugly. So I'll go to walkthrough videos. We'll save it. Okay, so now, first we gotta export our music here. So I'm gonna select all of our audio tracks here, and I'm gonna scoot it towards the beginning, just so our audio is gonna be starting right at the start of the audio file. I'll go to the end of it, and I'm gonna hit O, which is gonna set this marker over here for the out point of it. Now I'm gonna go up to File, Export Audio to AIFF. And we'll call it a beat edited. And so we'll save that. We'll hide that. Close some of this junk down. Okay, so now we're gonna go into After Effects, and I'm gonna show you guys how to use this file to make some snappy edits to the beat, and I'll show you a really easy way to do it. Okay, so I got my new project here. I'm just gonna drag my give me a beat edited audio file into After Effects here, and I'll go ahead and save this as give me a beat. And I'm gonna make a new composition, and I'm gonna use this preset that I use pretty much in all my projects that I do. It's 1280 by 720, 24p. I'll make it like 30 seconds long, just so we have enough room for our audio. So I'm gonna drag our audio into our timeline down here. Okay, so let's get cracking on the first step of working with the audio. I'm gonna trim this comp up a bit here. I'm gonna hold shift, which is, and drag the timeline marker, which is gonna snap to the end of our audio here. I'm gonna hit N, which sets the out point for our timeline, and I'm gonna right click on this gray area right here in our timeline, and I'm gonna go trim comp to work area. And so that's gonna make our comp exactly the size of our music, which will make it easier to work with here. Okay, so this is the first step we gotta do, is we gotta make all these little markers for the beats inside of our music here. And so what you're gonna need to do, I'm gonna have to switch keyboards here, but what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be going to the number pad on your keyboard, and that's why I had to switch keyboards, because my MacBook Pro here doesn't have a number pad on it, and I don't know how to do this if you don't have a number pad. So if you just have a keyboard, just plug that into your computer, just like I'm doing right now. It's kind of ghetto, but hey, you gotta do what you gotta do. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna be hitting the period key on the number pad here, which is only gonna play our audio. We don't have any video in this yet, but if we did, it wouldn't be playing. We're just playing the audio on our timeline down here. So I'm gonna hit period, and then when I hit period, in order to make keyframes at the beats, I'm gonna be hitting the asterisk button, which is right above the 9 on the number pad. It's not the asterisk on your main part of the keyboard, like where the 8 is. It's actually on the number pad right above the 9. So I'm gonna be hitting period on the number pad and then asterisk to make the keyframes. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that right now. You can do this on your project too. I'm just gonna be counting out quarter notes here. And depending on how tricky your animations are, you may wanna do more beats than that, or you may need to do less beats than that, but basically just do whatever makes sense for the music you're doing. I'll just do quarter notes here, so I'm gonna hit period. Okay, so you didn't see it while I was going because it didn't refresh yet. But so I hit period there, and then as the song was going along, I was just counting out the quarter notes along the song. So that's what all these little new markers here are in our timeline. These are our quarter notes in the song. I accidentally made one in the beginning there, and if you accidentally make any, just right click on the marker and go delete this marker. And so now, if I hit period, you'll notice that these match up to all the beats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So now we've got all these markers here, and this makes it a lot easier than just trying to basically do what we did in Final Cut, which was just stop the music when you're playing it on the beat. So this way we'd never have to worry about whether we're on the beat or not. So we know if our marker is right on one of these markers, that means that we're on a beat. Sometimes I think it's a good idea to have the whole notes marked out and have the quarter notes marked out. Right now we have the quarter notes marked out. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna make an adjustment layer, and this is gonna serve no purpose except for to have whole notes on it. So I'll show you what I mean. So I'll have a quarter as many notes on it. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the same thing I did before. I'm gonna hit period, and then I'm gonna hit asterisk. But I'm only gonna do it on the one beat. So here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Okay, I accidentally made this one in the beginning wasn't where I wanted it, so I'm just gonna get rid of it. So now I know where the measure starts over again at 1, because the 1 is a really good edit point. It's a stronger edit point than working with the 2, 3, or 4. In general, so that's why I like to have these, to just know when I'm looking at this, I'd be like, oh, like this point right here would be a really good point for an edit, just because it lands on the one there, which is a really strong beat. Okay, so now that we got these things done here, let's just start putting some stuff in our scene, start animating to the beat. I'm just gonna make a new solid. I'm gonna kind of zip through this stuff because this tutorial really isn't about, I'm gonna dock my effects panel over here. This tutorial is more about editing to the beat than it is doing all this stuff here, but feel free to follow along if you'd like. I'm just adding something here so our scene is kind of interesting. There we go, just adding some nice gradients in the background. Oh, that's honestly, that's fine for now. We might add some more stuff later, but I'm gonna add some text to the scene right now. So I'm gonna go, I'm gonna write, give me a beat. Because I'm white and it's cool to say that kind of stuff and pretend I'm not lame. So I'll write, give me a beat, and I'm gonna get rid of this stuff over here so we got some room. Okay, so I'm curious what beat this is right here. I'm hoping it's the one. Let me play it and check out. No, it looks like it's not. This looks like it's on the two there. So we're gonna need to manually add the one beat in here because we missed that. So I'm just gonna put it where I think the one is approximately. Looks like it should be about here if it's evenly spaced out. And then I'm just gonna hit the asterisk key on the number pad, and that's gonna add another marker there. So now I've got my one right here. So I think that would be a great point for our type to come in. So I'm gonna go ahead and add a new camera to this scene. We'll make it like 35 is fine. That's great, thank you very much for saying that. Okay, so I got a camera in here. I gotta make my type 3D in order to be doing cool stuff in space with it. So I'm gonna hit this little icon right there, make it 3D. I'm gonna hit P on the give me a beat there, and that's gonna bring down our position right there because that's what we wanna do. I think I'm gonna have it zoom past the camera and fly into right on the beat there. So I want it to land right on the beat here. So now that we have this marker here, if you hold shift in the timeline, it will, and you drag in your timeline there, it will snap the marker right onto the to our little keyframe marker here. So if I hold shift and I drag it to this one, I'm right on the beat there. So I'm gonna hit a keyframe here, the stopwatch, and set a position keyframe for it. And I'm gonna go forward a couple frames here. And what I'm gonna do here is I'm just gonna take this third value here is the Z value. So I'm gonna bring this forward in space because I want it to fly by the camera there. Okay, and I don't want it to be too harsh coming in. So what I'm gonna do is right click on this keyframe here and I'm gonna go to Easy Ease. So that will ease it in there. So I'm gonna hit N, and that is going to make our out point shorter there because I only wanna preview this little section right here. So hitting N on your timeline will set the marker, the end point there. So I'm gonna hit this RAM preview button here. Okay, so it looks like it's right on the beat, right where we want it. Okay, so we got it right on the beat there. And before I do anything else here, I'm gonna turn on the motion blur here because that works really well when you're dealing with fast moving stuff. It helps make it look more realistic. So you gotta check two things here. You gotta check this button right here, enable motion blur, and then check this box right here, which is gonna turn on motion blur for the individual layer itself because we want it on the type. So I'm gonna turn it on there. And instantly you'll notice that it's gotten some nice motion blur on it. So let's preview it again and it should look a little bit nicer. It's happening so fast that it's hard to see. I'll maybe make it a little bit slower. Cool, so we got that right on our beat there, right where we want it. So let's go to our next one right here, our next measure. And maybe we'll, let's see here. I'm gonna duplicate this type here. I'm gonna select it and hit Command D and make a duplicate of it. And I'm gonna turn off our other type for now. And let's see here. I'll just write something else that's really inspiring. Make it loud. 'Cause that's what you do with beats. You gotta make them loud. So I'm gonna grab it and I'm gonna drag it until it's right at the next point, at the one there. And let's see here, what do we want to do here? Yeah, that's what we want to do. If you hit Alt or Option key, and then you hit the close bracket sign on your keyboard, it's the rectangular brackets, it's not the parentheses. So if you hit Option and we're hitting the right close bracket key here, that will, so Alt plus the right key bracket, I don't know why I'm having a hard time saying that, is going to make the endpoint of your layer that is selected, it's gonna set the endpoint to wherever the marker is. So if I move it over here and I hit Option and the right close bracket sign, it's gonna make the layer end right there. Now, that's the shortcut to do it. You could also manually drag it here. Either way works fine. So I'm gonna turn on our layer again there. So now I have Give Me a Beat coming in on the one, and then Make It Loud coming in on the next one, on the next measure. So let's just check this out for now. Cool. It looks like, since our text is fully covering up the intro, or right when it comes on, I think we can end our Give Me a Beat right there. Let's see, one more. There we go. Just because that's gonna make a real nice clean transition there. It basically is covering up the whole screen when it comes on, so that's perfect for making a transition out of it. So let's check it again now that it's cleaned up a little bit. Okay. So let's do a little bit of a cool transition before we get to our next one here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna mask off all three of these words here, meaning we're gonna have three different layers with them on it. So the first one, I'm gonna take our mask tool up here and I'm gonna draw a mask over make, and I'm gonna duplicate that, and I'm gonna hit M with that selected to bring down the mask, and I'm gonna select that mask and then I'm gonna move it over so it's got the it. And then I'm going to duplicate this layer again, Command D, select the mask, double click on it, and move this one over to loud. So if I solo each one of these layers here, I've got all three of my words separated there. So now I can do something kind of cool as a transition now that I've got them separated. So I can, if I hold all three, if I hold Shift and select all three of them, hit P. I'm gonna set a keyframe for these guys here, and I'm gonna move down a little bit, and I'm gonna animate these all going. Let's see here. Let's have all of these going up. So I'm gonna select all of them, and I'm gonna move them all up. Now, right now, they're all moving up simultaneously, but that's the beauty of why we have them separated into three layers, is because we'll offset their timing so they're all moving independently. I'm going to select all of the keyframes here, and I'm going to hit Command and click on them, and that's going to revert all of them to just a normal linear keyframe. And then I'm going to select the first three there, and I'm gonna set these to easy ease. Okay, and now that I got these guys animated there, what I'm gonna wanna do is I'm gonna wanna animate these so they exit right on the beat there. So our first one, the make here, I'm gonna have that one start its transition out. I'm gonna bring that in point right on the second beat here. So this is our one, remember, so we have our two, our three, and our four, and then we get back to our one here, which is gonna be our new text there. So I'm gonna have this make start its exit on the two there. I'm gonna go down to my next keyframe there. Oh, it looks like it's right where we want it to be on that beat. And I'm gonna take the loud, and I'm going to have that start right there. So now we should get kind of a cool transition that all three of these are exiting right on the beat. So it'll be like, you know, boom, 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 and then it gets to the one there. So let's check this out. I don't know how this is gonna look. Let's see how it looks. Okay, so it's looking okay right now. I think I want them to be real fast. It looks like they're exiting pretty slowly. So I'm gonna grab all of these second keyframes, and I'm gonna shorten them up because I really want these things to just be like lightning quick leaving, because I want them really to emphasize the beat. If it's moving kind of slow, it's not really gonna emphasize the beat like we want. So let's try that again now that I made them real quick. Okay, that looks pretty cool. I got an idea here. I'm gonna watch this again, but I think I got an idea of how I want these to emphasize the beat even more than they already are. Let me check this out again though. Okay, so they're going, you know, one, two, three, just like that. I'm thinking, what about if we could make this, rather than one, two, three, what about if we could have it start right before the one, and we can have them go one, two, three, boom, and then right on the one. So let's try that out, and this might look cooler. So let's see here. See, this is a point where I think I might want to go back and add some more keyframes here. Because I only have quarter notes here, and I think I'm gonna wanna be working in eighth notes here. So I'm gonna go ahead and make a new track. I'm gonna delete these markers here. I wanna delete all of them. And I'm gonna go ahead and do the same thing I did before. I'm gonna hit period and then asterisk, but I'm gonna be hitting it on the eighth note. So I'm gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So let's go ahead and do that. Cool, so now I got eighth notes in here. So now, I can edit it to even smaller beats here, which is gonna let me do something. It's gonna let me do what I want here, because I got an idea. You know, you just get an idea and you follow it. So I want this to be we got three things here, so I'm gonna have it 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So I'm gonna want these on the 2, 3, 4 here, because this is gonna make a little bit of a snappier transition into the next type there. So let's go ahead and check this out, see if it looks cooler than before. Cool, so we got those going out on the beat there. Rather than the 2, 3, 4, I'm actually thinking I want this to be on the 1, 2, 3. So I'm gonna shift all these over one beat, and I'm just gonna check it out. So let's see how this looks. Now, it feels to me like all of these things are happening a little bit off the beat. And even though they're right, they look like they're right on the beat, they feel they feel like they're late on the beat. So I'm gonna take all of these and I'm gonna move them over like two frames, just because they felt like they weren't right in the pocket of where I want it to be for the animation. So I scoot them all over two frames. Now let's check this out. Maybe this will feel better. Yeah, it's right on the beat where I want it. One, two, three, one. Okay, so we got that rocking there. So let's go to our one right here. So hold shift and that'll lock us in on the one there. So let's duplicate our give me a beat and we're gonna drag it over. Let's see here, how should we have this one come in just to make it kind of interesting. Well, let's see here. Well, let's write something. We got give me a beat, make it loud. Oh yeah, I got it. Kick it. That's what the Beastie Boys would do anyways. They would definitely kick it. Okay, so we got, there we go. It should be coming in right on the beat there. But I don't think I want to reuse that same transition again. Let's see here. Let's see here. I'm gonna do the same thing I did to the make it loud, where I'm gonna duplicate these and I'm gonna make two versions of it so I can have them. I think I'll have them come in from opposite sides here. So I'm gonna set keyframes right on the beat where I want it. And now I'm gonna drag this one over to this side. And then this one over to this side. Select the end keyframes and add an easy ease so they kinda, slow down a little bit, look nicer. Let's check this out. Oh yeah, we're really rocking now. Okay, it looks like everything's right on the beat. Cool. I'm liking it. Let's this music is real energetic and it's not feeling very energetic, our video, because the music is coming in and it's just sitting there static. So I'm gonna do a cool little thing to the camera here, and I'm just gonna add a lot of dynamics to the scene just by doing this one simple thing. So I'm gonna select our camera, I'm gonna twirl down our options, and I am going to hit Alt on the stopwatch here and click on the stopwatch, and that's gonna open an expression for us. And Oh wait, it's not the point of interest, I'm sorry. Sorry guys. We're gonna hold Alt and click on the orientation there. There we go, that's the one we want. And we're gonna be adding a wiggle expression here, so type wiggle, open parentheses there, and this is gonna be the speed of the wiggle, so I'm gonna have it do something like 0.4, and that refers to it's gonna be wiggling 0.4 times a second. So we're going to do a comma, and then I'll do one right now and close parentheses. So we have wiggle, open parentheses, 0.4, comma, one, close parentheses. So let's check that out right now. So you'll see that it's kind of shifting around. The type is moving around, but it's not the type that's moving around. It's actually the camera. It's kind of like if the camera were on a raft in the ocean and it's just kind of bobbing up and down there. That's what our camera is doing here. Let's check this out. I might want to bump up the amount that it's wiggling a little bit, but let's just check it out for now. Just see how this looks. I'm going to turn off our music so you guys don't have to keep hearing this same track over and over again. Even though if you do videos for a living, that's what you get used to doing, is you get used to hearing it over and over and over again until you never want to hear it again. Okay, so you can see instantly there's some more movement in our scene here, but I think I'm going to turn it up a notch like the video is saying. So we've got a 0.9 and maybe like 2. No, not 12, 2. So let's check this out now. Okay, boom. Oh, now it's feeling loud. Now I'm feeling like I'm ready to kick it. Could definitely kick it now. This just instantly made our scene a lot more interesting. Now, obviously, we'd have to take this farther if it was a real project. But just that little trick right there is gonna go a long ways to making this thing feel more energetic. I think that it would be cool right on the make it loud there to have the entire color of the composition change here. So I'm gonna duplicate our blue solid there with the ramp on it. And I don't know, what color should we make this? Let's make it like some sort of weird yellow greenish. Whoa, that's really bright. Okay, maybe not that bright there. Maybe we'll make it a green color. Okay, and the reason I feel like we should do this is just so there's more interest happening between the edit points there, so that it's more visually, stimulating. So, I'm gonna go to this edit point that we used before to have our other text disappear, and I think that's where I want it to turn green. So I'm gonna have that green layer start right there. Okay. So let's check this out now that we're trying to emphasize. Give me a beat. Oh, make it loud. Kick it. Okay, now you'll notice because we had that orientation wiggle on our camera here that we're seeing this type up here. So it looks like we're gonna wanna make it disappear when it's ended there, just so it's not cutting into the shot there. So I'm gonna select all three of these, hold Alt and the right bracket, and that's gonna make the end point of these right here so that by the time it's over here, where it was showing up here, we're gonna get it out so it disappears. Give me a beat, oh, what? Make it loud, why not? Kick it. Okay, something else we could do to the shot, something I do a lot to add interest to my compositions when I want them to feel exciting, is I'm gonna go ahead and make a new adjustment layer here. And let's see here, I'm gonna add a curves adjustment. And I'm gonna bring down the curves here, which is gonna make the whole thing darker. I'm gonna go up to my mask tool up here, I'm gonna select the ellipse tool. And now I'm just gonna double click on this ellipse tool now that it's an ellipse icon, and that's gonna make an ellipse mask the size of our layer there. I'm going to go to our mask option down here on this adjustment layer we just created. I'm gonna go to subtract, and then I'm gonna twirl down the mask here, and I'm gonna increase the feather to something like 136. And so that's darkening the edge right now, and that's sort of what we want, but actually what we want is some sort of like flickering edge around it. Which is going to just make it more interesting. It just adds one more level of interest to it. So I'm gonna hit T on the layer, which brings up opacity. I'm gonna hit Alt on the stopwatch, which is gonna make another expression. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna make another wiggle expression. So this time we're not gonna be wiggling the position or the orientation like we did for the camera. We're gonna be wiggling the value of the opacity, which is gonna give it a little bit of a flicker look. So I'm gonna want this to be a lot faster than our other wiggle, something like, 15. And the second value is, I'm gonna set it to like 50, which means that it's gonna go up or down 50 percentage points here. I'm gonna set my opacity to 0 there, because that's gonna make it so, since we have 50 as the amount here, that means since it's set to 0 here, that the maximum value that we're gonna allow the Wickle is gonna be 50. So the max opacity it's ever gonna reach is 50% there. So now that we got this going, let's do another RAM preview now that we have our little flicker there. Okay, it looks to me like the flicker's a little bit too fast there, so I'm gonna set this down to 10. And I think I'm also gonna wanna increase the feather there, just so it doesn't look like it's only flickering right on the edges. I want it to be a little bit smoother, so we'll set the feather to like 220. All right, here. It doesn't add a lot to it, and in fact, I would probably take it down a little bit. I feel like it's too much right now. We'll maybe make the max wiggle value 20, just so it's something real subtle on it. You know, we don't need to scream at people with our effects. You know, being subtle is a good thing. So let's turn back on our music here and let's do this final outro, because we got our last beat that's right here, and we should be doing something cool there. Or is that our last beat? Oh, it looks like we got one more full measure here that we don't have accounted for. Let's go ahead and check this out and see what we're... Okay, yeah, so it looks like we got a whole measure here. We got a whole measure to account for to put something in there, so dang it, we're gonna put something in there. We will not stand for boring videos. Okay. Okay, so I'm gonna go down to this next one here. And I think I'm going to go to an old rap staple. When you don't have anything at all to say, it's usually good to just default to an or a yeah. So we're gonna add an and a yeah to this, because that is really gonna make this video just amazing. So I'm gonna hit S on our layer here, and I'm gonna position this in the middle here. So I'm gonna have this on the 2 beat one. Actually, I think I'm gonna have it happen between the 2 and the 3 there. Just to be a little bit more interesting. I'm gonna duplicate the and I'm gonna add a yeah, because you can't have an without a yeah. Let's see here, and I think I'll add it between the 3 and the 4. I don't even know if this is gonna be interesting, but whatever. Yeah. Okay, that is so, that really just added a lot. I'm gonna go ahead and move this a little bit closer. And I think I'm gonna have the yeah. This is an old staple of mine. When you wanna end a video, you just have the text fly towards the screen right on the beat, and then that makes a perfect point to just make a hard cut there and just have your video go to black, and then you are over. Now when this thing zooms forward, I kinda want it to zoom forward so it's so that the text is gonna be making the screen completely white there. And then that is gonna be our edit point right there. And we'll do that inside a final cut there. So we'll trim it up in Final Cut when we output it. So let's just check this out and make sure it's right on the beat where we want it. Okay, So it looks like it's flying in right on the beat where we want. I'm just gonna trim our yeah a little bit. A little bit premature of a yeah, if I do say so myself. Cool, so it looks like this video of ours is ready to render. So I'm gonna set the endpoint back to zero here. I'm gonna set the out point. I don't need all this extra seconds here. So I'm gonna shrink that a little bit. I'm gonna go to composition, make movie. I will set our format to animation is fine. That all looks good there. One last thing to mention, since I was working with this gradient here, if you're working with gradients, it's really gonna, you're gonna do yourself a lot of favors if you change this this little thing right here that says 8-bit color right here. We're gonna wanna change that to 16 bits. Now you can change it by going up into the menus there, or you can just hit Alt and click on that 8-bit right there and you'll see it change to 16-bit. And now what that's gonna do is it's gonna smooth over any sort of banding issues. It's not gonna completely fix it, but it's really gonna make it a lot smoother because you're working with a whole lot more colors than you are in the 8-bit color. So I'm gonna set that to 16 there just so we have a smoother gradient. And it looks like we're ready to render. We'll just put it on the desktop for now. That's fine. It's fine if you're like me and you really don't mind having really messy desktops. And I never throw things away. I just make a folder and I just call it desktop and then I put it in there. And then I just have endless amounts of folders called desktop or desktop junk. So, and now we wait for it to render. All right, so our video finished rendering there. So I'm gonna drag it from my desktop into Final Cut here. And let's see here, what is going on? I'm actually gonna make a new sequence so it conforms to the format of our video here. So new sequence, double click on it, drag our comp just right onto the window there. It's gonna say, do you wanna match the settings? And I'm gonna say, I sure do. Okay, so now that we've got that in here, let's drag our give me a beat right in there. Oh wait, no, I need the other give me a beat. That's the non-edited one. Okay, here we go. Let's drag the right one in, shall we? Okay, so this should match up now. Cool, so we successfully took it from Final Cut into After Effects, and then now we're back in Final Cut to do our final little edit. So I hope that was helpful, seeing my workflow and how I transfer from Final Cut to After Effects and how I deal with music in there. If you have any questions, just drop it in the comments below, and otherwise I'll see you guys next time. Bye.